I owe you.
You owe me. That cannot be comfortable for you.
Hey, you should kiss me right now.
Day seized!
We're even.
A plus, Winger! I know a life-changing kiss when I see one. Wow-wee!
Yeah. You.
Him. Man is evil.
Green Deal wins.
Eat that, Simmons.
Somebody. You probably hear that all the time.
Not as much as I should.
Oh, professor.
What? I'm not a professor.
But you're at Greendale, and you're old.
I'm a student.
Yikers.
Yeah, it's pretty much yikers for me, too.
Well, I guess I can make an exception, professor.
You know, I can't do this.
What? But this is your car.
Keep it.
But...
Professor Slater, quick question.
You know the answer, Mr. Winger. I don't date students, even if you are no longer in my statistics class.
I'm actually kind of seeing someone right now, thank you very much.
Really? How's that going?
Fine for now. She's smart and pretty, but sometimes I feel like she's just waiting for me to stop talking and take off my pants.
She is.
I've never been someone's dirty little secret.
I've never had a dirty little secret. It's so unprofessional. But the sneaking does make the sex 38% hotter.
Wow, you do like statistics, don't you? Hey, midterms and whatever.
Talk. Professor Slater, there's that transcript you wanted. Jeff, I didn't expect to see you here. Hopefully I'm not...
interrupting.
You know, we laugh. But the fact is, student-teacher relationships do happen, and they are a magnet for lawsuits, so we do stay vigilant. In fact, physically attractive students and faculty are actually placed on a watch list and are ranked by their potential to incite fraternization.
You rank people by how hot they are?
You got it. Number two.
Dean Pelton.
Yes, Professor Seven. Slater.
I'll return this tomorrow.
Okay, then. You guys be extra careful now. Two people of your rankings in this smaller room with this type of lighting and... his upper body and what her heels and hemline are doing to enhance what were already quite a few favors from God. It's all the more important to keep it tasteful.
I think he might have ruined...
it's dead.
Mr. Winger, would you come to my office? We never finished our intercourse.
I have study group right now, and... nobody uses intercourse to mean anything other than sex. Look, this is a wall of windows. My study group is behind it.
I know.
Look, As soon as we touch, the blinds will open and six annoying but lovable misfits will be staring at us.
Come on, what are the odds?
Fine.
Now, is that so bad?
Hey, could you open the back door?
I'm gonna join you at that dance. But as a novice boyfriend, can I get a map of the minefield known as women's Valentine expectations?
Every day of the year, I want you to do what makes you happy.
Tomorrow, I'm gonna be happy spending the night with an insatiable statistics professor.
Happy Valentine's Day. Perfect boyfriend.
Yeah, that's me.
You're leaving.
My girlfriend is pregnant.
Pierce said you're gay.
Yep. As the sunrise, and I'm deeply ashamed. I'm just glad I have friends like Pierce to keep honest. This is slightly wrong.
Too much tongue?
Just enough, but it's Pierce.
You mean the guy who decided he doesn't want men touching his ex-stepdaughter, but who divorced my mom for our housekeeper?
Could be the same guy, yeah.
Amber?
Amber, there you are.
What are you doing?
She's respecting her elders.
See, Troy, did you think I was a hypocrite? That I wouldn't really... Okay, ow, that really... Ooh, okay, that really...
I don't understand you, Britta! I don't understand you at all!
You know what? Totally wrong room. Will you get the door?
She's had enough! She's had enough!
Well, let's focus on you, the forbidden fruit that is the ex-stepdaughter of a casual acquaintance.
Oh, oops. Don't want to lose that.
Why do you have a $25,000 check from Pierce?
Tuition for fashion school.
Not photography school?
You caught me. Maybe I'll just buy a car.
And you could just do that, huh?
Well, it helps that he's kind of desperate and stupid. Did you want to be a good person right now? Or did you want to be with me?
The group would be thrilled. The wounded soldier fantasy means we're moments from doing it, right?
Yeah, can you feel that tension? It's a miracle we still have clothes on.
You're right, you know. I am a phony. I try to act compassionate because I'm afraid that I'm not.
Oh, please. I invented phony. You care about people. I accuse you of faking to convince myself I'm not such a jerk.
Jeff, you help people more than I do, and you don't even want to. You're not a jerk, you're fine. Especially now that I've repaired your overworked torso with my trembling feminine fingers.
Yes, too much sexual tension, damn bursting.
You know, it would totally serve them right if we did it here in the study room.
Oh my God, could you imagine?
I can't stop imagining.
Neither can I. Media clip.
Oh, yeah, that would be brilliant of me.
Look, you got the drop on me. I lost. Let me do this for you.
Be pretty crazy if I shot you right now, huh?
Christine Hollinsworth. Brittany Baker. Miss Danielle Harmon. Amy Smith!
Jeff Winger, do not get back with Slater.
I love you.
thought you left.
I couldn't go.
What happened?
I guess as we were driving away, I finally started living in the moment. And I realized that in the moment, Greendale is where I belong. What are you doing out here?
Oh, you know, Britta and Slater told me they love me.
Really? What did you do?
I ran away. I don't know. It's hard. Slater makes me feel like I do when I write my New Year's resolutions. She makes me feel like the guy I want to be. And Britta makes me feel like the guy I am 3 weeks after New Year's, when I'm back to hitting my snooze button and screening my mom's phone calls. Back to who I really am. So, do you try to evolve? Or do you try to know what you are?
I don't know. I wish I could live two lives. One of me would go with Vaughn, and one of me could stay here.
Yeah, one of me could be back with Slater, and the other could try it with Britta. And then we could all get together for some weird foursome. I guess I gotta deal with it.
Good luck.
I'm glad you're staying.
Tribe's assignment for tomorrow is to tell me which tool that is. Questions? I have a question, but not for you.
It's for Britta. Britta, I love you. Now, I know this puts you in an awkwardly powerful position, but I have to know right now, in front of everyone, do you love me too?
More than anything in the world.
Really?
Yeah.
So it begins. Mm. The greatest relationship ever known.
Good, I'm gonna love you forever.
I don't believe you.
Why? Don't you want me to?
No, I do. Bring it.
Doesn't it make you want to cry?
Something like that. Excuse me.
I downloaded a song that makes me think of you. Let's listen to it, each using one earbud. Sorry I'm late. I was in my car loving Britta. I guess I just love you too much.
Not half as much as me.
Oh. Jeff, do you think you'll marry Britta?
I'd like to see someone stop me.
I just peed a little.
And here, propose.
Oh! I got it! Jeff Winger, will you marry me?
Yeah, of course.
No problem.
Perfect, I'll be right back.
Oh, thank the Lord you're getting married. I was so worried about your souls ever since you had premarital sex on the table. Oh!
Awesome!
Because everyone's gonna be pretty embarrassed on Monday, huh?
Nah, everybody just got a little bit drunk. Nobody did anything that bad, right?
What are we doing?
Yeah, what are we doing?
This is a bad idea, right?
Yeah.
Okay.
Oh no, what happened?
Minor head wound. Oh my God, what smells amazing?
Oh, someone wants pie!
You make a good nurse.
Oh my God. They taste just like regular sized pies.
Oh, yay!
Happy housewarming.
Oh, cool. Thanks, Pierce.
Hey, while we're alone, I just want to say thanks for letting me live with you.
Sometimes I feel like making desserts is the only thing I'm good for in the group.
But now it's time for me to try and make it on my own. Just like you did.
I can't help but worry about you, Annie.
Yeah, I don't think you should open it.
No, what? What are you talking about?
You're very important to me.
Crap. I was not supposed to eat your stuff. We all made an agreement. Crap! I was not supposed to say that out loud. Crap! Okay, cards on the table. I'm really high right now.
Oh!
Seriously,
you stop and give
me. No, I want to give you something else. A water pig. A speedboat. Two water pigs.
I can't believe I'm feeding my pies to a drug addict.
Drug addict? You're a pie pusher. You push pies to get love.
Give it, Pierce. Stop it. It feels fun.
I'm sorry. I just had a weird deja vu. Good. I'll start with a story about a horrible fate befalling innocent people, and then I'm curious to get individual reactions. Once upon a time, there's a couple in a car in the woods making out or something. I think I heard something.
It's just the sound of my heart, baby. Huh.
In the news tonight, top story, an escaped convict from the asylum has escaped, and he's mental and he's on the loose and stuff.
Oh my God, that sounds dangerous.
Oh, I'm sure it's no biggie, but I am a horny man. I'm only half present.
He was last seen in the woods and has a thingy for a hand, a hook thing where his hand should be. You know what I mean?
That sounds dangerous.
Fine, I'll get out and look. But then I'm entitled to sex. Ah! I'm getting stabbed with this hook hand thing!
Oh my God, no! I was right! And the woman was screaming and screaming and the man got killed.
And the winner is...
Howie Schwartz!
I just need a minute.
This is my show. It's about me and all my friends on Abbott TV. My happy place. Nothing but fun. Nothing but laughs and smiles, and then we rerun. For those times when life's too hard to face, I'll find some happy in my happy place.
Abbott's Happy Community College Show is filmed before a live audience inside of my head.
Oh, Ben.
Jeffrey, what are you doing?
Look, if he doesn't remember her, then this wouldn't bother him. My logic is flawless. Doesn't that bother you? That bothers you.
Things got so ugly, I hesitate to even show you this footage.
Your Honor. I may not have a right arm, but I am armed with what's right. My client, Miss Edison, did rob several drugstores, and yes, she did stab several pharmacists. But let's talk about the bigger crime. That someone so beautiful has been removed from society.
Miss Edison, you are hereby released from Greendale Insane Asylum.
Are you sure you don't have a problem with our age difference?
Yeah, I wish you were even younger. Now, come on. The others are waiting. We've got a prime timeline to destroy. It's worse than I thought. They made lame Jeff too lame to leave Greendale. He's got to take that job.
But how do we make him do that?
By turning the study group against him. So he'll run screaming from this rancid cocoon into the welcoming arms of darkness. How hard is that to understand?
It's not. I just like when you talk down to me like a child.
Annie, I'm home.
Hey there. How was your day? Did anything funny happen?
Oh, who cares?
How was your day?
Good. Sebastian did some drawing.
Sebastian? Let's look at him. Sebastian!
Sebastian!
Oh, back to your child area.
Oh.
I'll let you go, Annie. With my hands, my head, the heart, which cynics say is code for penis, wants what it wants. But I let you go.
The others are coming. I think you should kiss me goodbye or you might regret it for the rest of your life.
What about you?
I'll regret the kiss for a week. I'm in my 20s. Who cares?
Are you guys doing an unauthorized finale in here? Not cool.
Abed, I know it gives you comfort to see everything through that meta lens, but we were just saying goodbye to the room.
For season 6. Season 7, who knows? It's out of our hands. Too many variables.
Cool.